Welcome, folks. Welcome, fellow hams. What time does the 7 o'clock show start? 7:30. No, it starts about 7:05, and it's 7:05. So welcome to all of you who came. It's great to have you here. I'm sure there'll be some more that show up. But we're starting the pregame show now, and that is going to be led by AK4AO, Doug, who's going to talk to us about this, the Vienna Wireless Society website, which is actually very cool and very clever, and there's stuff about that that you're going to learn tonight that you probably didn't know already. Before we get started, all you talkers back there need to pay attention to this. This is important, Harry, and Brendan, and Mike. This is important, and Teresa. Okay, I know names. So we're being allowed to use this room tonight instead of the cafeteria, or we were forced to use this room tonight. But there is something that's very important. They're very clear they don't want any food in this room. Why? I'm not sure, but they don't want any food in this room. So when we go for our snack, our calorie percuso thing, you have to go out that door, and there will be food out there when it's time, but you can't bring anything back in here to eat or drink. Everybody okay with that? If you have any problems with that, talk to me later. But for the moment, just be clear. The other thing is, welcome to make yourselves comfortable. Try not to move the tables. They want the tables back exactly the way they were. Why, I don't know. But they want them the way they were when we found them. And I think they all are, except for the ones back there and a couple up here. Okay, any questions before we get going? I'm really glad you're all here because Doug is going to teach us something that we need to know. And I'll turn it over to him now. Thanks, Doug.
Okay, thanks, Bill. Everybody hear me okay? All right, great. Okay, well, we're going to talk about the club's website tonight. And before I really get into it, I want to do something that may help the live streamers. There is a slide deck version of this presentation, and I want to show anyone who might be live streaming or want to look at this later how to get it first of all. So, this is the homepage of the website at viennawireless.net. If you hover your mouse over the word meetings and click on presentations, and in this case, I have to scroll down a little bit. Okay, you'll see presentations from past meetings. You'll see live streams. You may see slides. If there's some other kind of material, a PDF of any sort that somebody wants to go with their presentation, it would be listed here. And they're in reverse chronological order, which means that since I don't yet have the slides for the second presentation tonight, the slides for this presentation are first on the list. So you just click this link and you could download the presentation if you are either live streaming or I want to refer to it later. Okay, well, while some people may be downloading, a little bit of background on the website. This version of the website really was created in 2015 to better meet the needs of the club. At that time, we had lost our webmaster and the site had drifted into less than current content. And I had been into the site some because of Winterfest activities and kind of knew how my way around the old site. And Thor and Ralph Smith had some really good ideas about how to redevelop the site. But I was the one who said, well, I think I have time to do it, never having done a website before. Their recommendation was to put it in a management system for websites. And the most commonly used one of those is WordPress. So this is a WordPress site. And that means that WordPress provides a layer of software with a lot of functionality with the end result that with an hour's time you can do a lot more in WordPress than you could by, say, coding in HTML or using some lower level approach. I'll just show you one thing. You may not have tried this before, but in the Chrome browser you can zoom. So let me zoom the home page a little bit and see what happens. So I'm going to make it bigger. And oops, what happened? Well, the menu just changed shape. And it does that so if you're on a tablet or a cell phone or whatever, the menu can still work. So that's the kind of thing that WordPress does for you. I didn't do any coding to make that happen. But let me go back. I'm going to keep it at about 150% of the normal size. I think you'll be able to read it better that way. See, we also moved the site to a hosting service. You know, we pay about $10 a month for somebody to be there if something goes bump in the night or the day. And that gives the site a place to live permanently. We also added in some connections to PayPal so that you can pay your dues or donate to the club via the website. And we've occasionally used PayPal for, you know, for other special occasion things. We don't see any of the PayPal transaction on our website, so we're not collecting any credit card numbers or personal information associated with transactions, but we send you over to PayPal when we want to do something like that. Okay, well, if you've used the site at all, I'm sure you're familiar with the home page and the menu. These pictures are selected at random each time you hit the site. And by the way, all you guys with cell phones, pictures are solicited, so I'd love to have some more to put up on the site this way. They have to have a strong horizontal emphasis because of the form factor of these header photos. And let me actually go back to the homepage now. And you probably know that the homepage is going to tell us about upcoming events on the site. And this is a good time for a call out to Mike Imony, who is the man behind keeping this homepage current and dealing with the last minute changes and so on. So Mike, hooray for that effort. And Mike also is deputy webmaster and is learning the internals of the website. So if I should be unavailable, there is a backup. And it's a good time for a commercial message. If you scroll down a little bit, you'll see the announcement about NAQP RIDI at my house tomorrow afternoon. What's RIDI? It's radio teletype. Not done on the old machines that used to go kerchunk, kerchunk, but all that's done on computers now. And it is still an available contesting mode. There are still a fair number of contests in RIDI, and there is some DX activity in RIDI, although that's kind of declining in turn versus other modes, like FT8, for example. There's a little calendar here, and you can click on it and find out what's going on various dates. And then the next four upcoming events are called out down here. But something you may not have seen before is there's a search box right here. And if you put something in here of interest, oh, let's try, let's try spelling it better. Come here. Let me try field day. You'll find the various pages that have something about field day, and you'll find field day posts that at this point are probably from last year. So field day chairman, you might want to take a look at this and see some of the things that were done last year, like the mess plan. Well, yeah, you were there, but you may not know about all the planning documents that were behind it. Okay. Let me move on a little bit. So I'll go to about page 8 of the slide deck. Now, you've seen the menus, and you've probably pulled them down and clicked on something. Something that you may not know is that or say the events menu, you can also click on the word events. You don't have to go down into the pop-out menu or drop-down menu. So if I do that and scroll down so you can see it, I actually get a bigger rendition of the club calendar. And I find this useful if I want to say, hey, what's coming up in the next 3 months, and pull out my phone and get it on my personal calendar. Okay, so how about a quiz? Besides doing these things, what else do you guys find on the website that you find useful? Anybody? Okay. The member lists and contacts, what else? Well, yeah. Okay. There's a couple good things. Any more? Yep. All right. Okay. Well, we're not going to do the password on the live stream, okay, but there is a password for the membership list, and we'll go there in just a second. So ask anybody in leadership or somebody you know in the club if you don't know the password, and they will probably know. You can certainly ask me or, you know, any of the officers, directors, frequent attendees. Okay, you can do several other things, so let me show you some of them. So, for example, if you need to pay your dues, and some folks are a little bit delinquent in their dues at this point, there are a couple ways to navigate there, but I'm going to do members and then join or renew. And if you scroll down, you will see a PayPal button. And if you click there, it'll take you to your PayPal account. And you just have to tell us your call sign, your name, so we can identify you. And you'll complete a PayPal transaction, and your dues will land in the treasury, and the membership chairman will get an email saying that you did this. There is a membership status on the membership list, so why don't we take a look at the member list now?
Or if you don't have a PayPal account, you can go to PayPal and just use a credit card if you want to use PayPal. Alternatively, dues can be paid by check to the club P.O. box or collected here at the meeting.
Right.
And that story is actually on this page as well. Okay, but let me go to the membership list. That is one of the things that I use, you know, all the time, and it's down a little bit. And because the browser has already seen me put in the password, I don't have to do it again. Your first time, you will need the password. And there is a search function on the membership list that you may or may not have used. I'm going to restrict the search because I don't want to show too much personal information for people who haven't given me permission, so I'll go to somebody who has. And in the search box, you can put a name, you can put a call sign, you can put a street name. Now, that's both a good and a bad thing, because if you put in Robert, you'll get a first name of Robert, a last name of Robertson, or Roberts Avenue. So you will have to be a little bit careful with the search box, but a call sign, of course, is unique. Another thing that you could try is if you're thinking about doing VE exams, there's a credentials field. And you can type in ARRLVE, and you'll find all the VEs who have their credentials correctly recorded in the club. And by the way, you need to tell Harry if you become a VE or your credentials will never show up here. That's not automatic.
Answer the question of, do you have dues due?
Yep, let me go back to me for a minute.
And we'll scroll across and see all of the fields that are publicly displayed. Oops. Yep, let me. Yep, well. All right. I'm kind of in a funny position with respect to the keyboard. Okay, so you can get my name. You can find that I have paid. Address and phones, email, certifications, and spouse name are the fields that we display. We collect some other things in the database, but you know, we don't display quite everything. Like, are you a past president? That sort of stuff is not, you know, as immediately useful.
There are a few members that wish not to be on this public list. If that's your desire not to be on this public list, even though it's password protected, you still don't want to be on this list, let Harry or myself know, and we'll set you up so that you're not on the public list. If you don't want your street address shown, we would probably ask you to remove your hold.
Yeah, it's either all or nothing.
It's just a binary flag of can you display this or not.
Or do we have to send changes to you?
You have to send changes
to Harry or to Mike or me. There's one more question here, I think.
That the names of those people that don't want to be included on this public list are still behind the query in the database, though, right?
Yes, those.
The database is everybody because we need a complete record of who's in the club.
This is just what's available via
the website. There is a larger database that has everybody that's, you know, available to the small number of need-to-know people. Yes?
Everybody
knows
that.
Yes, that's a theoretical question.
The password for that database is severely limited in who has it and is changed periodically.
Okay.
Well, another big
800 people in the master database. There are the silent keys that we have in the club. There are members that left the area to go on overseas duty and then will come back in 3 years and we'll put them back in the list. Jack, are you here?
I'm here.
Thank you for coming down home.
Okay,
let's move on a little bit so we finish. A big set of activities on the site revolve around Winterfest. If you click on just the word Winterfest here, you'll get background on Winterfest. If you click, say, Winterfest 2019 vendors, you'll get a map of the table layout of the gym at Winterfest, and you'll get a list of who's coming and what they're selling. So I find that useful. Okay, another, sorry?
Visible to the public, so
they yes.
Coming.
Yes,
this.
Anybody
can view this. The only page on here that's password protected other than the admin pages themselves that require a special login is the membership list. Okay, another page that I think is probably useful but is not hit very much is under About and Useful Links. So let's take a look at that. Okay, so here are some interesting pages. Like, for example, I didn't know about this link, the University of Arkansas Amateur Radio Club homepage. Well, they have taken the FCC database and periodically update that and provided a search engine that lets you more easily look up somebody in the FCC database. So some things on vintage gear and so on. I'm sure there are a lot more links like this, and contributions, comments, and so on are welcome. Okay, well, we have a few more minutes. Some things you could try on your own. I told you the site was cell phone friendly, and you can go ahead and give it a try if you haven't. Now, someone a while ago didn't know how to refresh the page on their cell phone, and I'm not sure how it always works, but on my cell phone with the Chrome browser, if I put my finger on a page on an area that is not a link and pull down, that's the way to refresh the page. So if you're seeing like the meeting venue and you think it might have changed a day ago and your browser still has the old one, that's the thing to try. Of course, in the computer version of Chrome browser, it's this circular icon here. Oh, okay, and Bill is showing me that on the iPhone there is an icon like this up in the address bar. Okay, some other things to try. Take a look at the public service pages and the makers pages. Explore the field day pages and you'll find a lot of photos from past years. And the way that is working now is that we have a Flickr site that the club owns, and when people just send me photos from field day, they go on the Flickr site. We also link to some folks' Flickr sites where they have, you know, put their stuff up in Flickr, and we just put the link on this photos page. That's a lot of fun. And another thing to try on your own is next time you go to a club event like NAQP Ready tomorrow, bring your cell phone, take a few pictures, make sure you're sensitive to some folks who would rather not be in club pictures, and contribute them, and hopefully they'll end up on the website. Okay, what questions do you have in the last couple minutes?
The URLs changed from .org to .net recently or something?
.org should still work, but viennawireless.net is the preferred address.
Does .net not work on your phone,
Mike?
.org did?
Did not.
But .net just worked on my phone.
.org did own the domain.
Okay, it just did. There it is. So...
So it's a local issue. We'd have to debug it offline. Yeah.
Reminder to everybody that we also have a Facebook page, so loosely tied to web stuff. And I've updated some photos of tonight's presentation like I do at every meeting. So there's also meeting. I take some information from the website, like the meeting date and time and location, and I put that into the Facebook page as well.
Yeah, possible future
developers to get the website and the Facebook page a little bit more tightly integrated.
Everybody has some stuff that they want to share on the Facebook page, just let me know, and we'll make it happen.
Okay, thanks,
Brandon.
Anything else?
I used
the Facebook page.
Okay, well, we're
about 7:30. We are, so thank you, Doug, for teaching us stuff that we may or may not have already known, but I certainly didn't know a lot of that stuff.